Hi friends, in this video we are going to learn about the basic concepts of spherical mirrors. Observe the images. Observe carefully. Are there any differences in the images? Observe carefully. Are the images formed by bulged surface same as the images formed by plane mirrors? Now, look at the image. Is this a plane mirror? Why is it showing small images? Do you know the reason? Look here is a mirror. Observe the image. It is upside down. Why is it happened so? Look here. What is the reason behind it? We know the first law of reflection. According to that, angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection at the normal. This law is true for all surfaces, whether it is a plane surface or a curved surface. It is very easy to find a normal at any point on the plane surface. But for a curved surface, it is not straightforward. Let us find the normal for a curved surface by an activity. For this, we require foam sheet and broomsticks. Look here, this is foam sheet. If we consider the foam as a plane mirror, then each stick acts as a normal to the plane of foam at that point. Now, let us bend the foam inwards as shown here. What happens to the sticks? We will notice that all the sticks intersect at a point. Still, they are representing the normal. Look here, observe carefully, intersecting point is changing as the curve, that means the bending changes. Now, if we bend the foam outwards, then we will see that the sticks seem to diverge as shown here. Still, they are acting as normal at that point. This gives us an idea of what is happening with the spherical mirrors. A concave mirror will be like the foam bent inwards. A convex mirror will be bent outwards, as shown here. Now let us know about the basic concepts of the spherical mirrors. Look here, observe carefully, Concave mirror is a spherical mirror whose reflecting surface is towards the center of the sphere, of which the mirror is a part. Look here. Now observe here, convex mirror is a spherical mirror whose reflecting surface is away from the center of the sphere, of which the mirror is a part. Now look both the mirrors. Concave mirror is inside reflecting and convex mirror is outside reflecting. Now center of curvature. Center of curvature is the center of the sphere of which the spherical mirror forms a part. The letter C is used to denote the center of curvature. Look here, in concave mirror, C is there. Now observe convex mirror. Radius of curvature. Radius of curvature is the radius of the sphere of which the mirror is a part. The letter R is used to represent the radius of curvature. In convex mirror also same. Now observe both the mirrors. Now pole. Pole is the midpoint of the aperture of the spherical mirror. The letter P is used to denote the pole of a mirror. See P in the image. Observe P in both the mirrors. Now principal axis. Principal axis is the straight line passing through the pole and the center of curvature of a spherical mirror. Look here, the line is passing through P and C. For convex mirror is also same. The line which is passing through P and C is known as principal axis. Observe in both cases. Now, the normal at any point of a spherical mirror is a straight line obtained by joining that point with the center of the curvature. The normal at point A on the mirror is the line AC obtained by joining A to the center of the curvature of the mirror. Normal at any point on a spherical mirror is equal to the radius of the sphere. Look here, AC is the normal at point A. In convex mirror is also same. Observe the normal at point A. AC is the normal. Observe in both of the mirrors, AC is the normal at point A. Now, principal focus, that is F, we can call it as F, focus. The ray of light parallel to the principal axis of a concave mirror after reflection pass through a point or converge at a point on the principal axis. This point is referred to as principal focus or focal point of the mirror. The letter F is used to denote the focus in the convex mirror. All the rays parallel to the principal axis are diverging from a point on the principal axis. That point is known as focus or focal point. Observe in these two mirrors. Now focal length. Focal length is the distance between the pole and the focus of the mirror. That is the distance between P and F. It is represented by the letter F. That is small f. Look here, focal length of concave mirror. Now observe in convex mirror. The distance between P and F is known as focal length and denoted by small f. Now observe in both the mirrors.